Hi guys! Finally, we reached the point where we can test our strategy. I will use a simple backtesting Python framework to perform the test. You can install it using pip. The author of this framework provides a simple example how to use it. You can see it on the screen. Well, we must implement our own strategy. Let us start from the initialization and define all variables that we need. You can see that we can load our saved policy using TensorFlow API. And we must get initial state of the policy as we are using QRNN network. So, init function is implemented. Now we need to implement next function. This function will be called on every new step. Just from the beginning, we need to collect first 10 days. And after that, we can feed our observation dictionary. On each step, we will update it and pass to the policy. After we created the observation dictionary, we need to create a time step object, because our policy needs this object as input. I created a simple function that converts our observation data to the time step object. The most important here is the observation data and step type. So, we got our time step, and now we can get action from the policy. As you may see, run policy function resets the policy state if the step type is equal to 0, and returns action and new policy state. Next, we need to update our position states and execute action. At the end of the next function, we increment the counter and reset everything to initial states, because we want to simulate start of a new episode. Okay, we have implemented our strategy. Now we need data for testing. We can use Panda Data Reader to get daily data from the Yahoo Finance. First, let us try to test our strategy on the Intel stock. We will take history from 1 year. Now we create a backtest object and we can start the test. You can see the test result is 106%. Wow! But our backtesting framework starts calculation from 100%. That means we got only 6. Not so bad for our agent policy, which we do not really train. To be honest, this policy doesn't perform well. Mostly we will lose money. We can try to test AMDStock instead of Intel. As you may see, we have about minus 40%. So here we can see side-by-side comparison performance of our strategy on AMD and Intel stocks. Well, now you know how we can use the agent policy with backtesting frameworks. In the same way, you can use the policy with the real trading environment, if you are using Python. In case if you are using another language, you can deploy the policy using the Flux framework and access to it using REST API. I hope all these videos were interesting. If you like it, don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next episode. Bye.